We are Minerva and Paola, and our presentation is about a research project we are developing in our students' research group called Music and Resistance. And the title of our research is called The Impact of a Pandemic in the Punk Scene of Chapinero, Bogotá. So first, as many of you may not be aware or do not know the context of Colombia, we want to make a small presentation about the context of Colombia. So we have to say that it's a country with a lot of structural violence. It's a very unequal state regarding social classes mainly. And there are some key issues nowadays that we have to take into account regarding the COVID crisis. One of them is the immigration from Venezuela, which has raised a lot of xenophobic thinking. There is in Bogotá a lot of displacement due to the armed conflict. So many people that used to live in the rural areas have arrived to Bogotá due to this forced displacement. There are high levels of poverty. During the COVID crisis, massacres have increased also. And there is a problem with workers and with lower social classes, because mainly the data that we can see there, 41.8% of the jobs in Bogotá are informal jobs, so they have a lot of impact of the pandemic, because mainly they sell their products on the streets, and as there is no people on the streets, so they have no income. To talk about our research, what we are going to do is to share with you a cartography we are doing about the punk territoriality in Chapinero, or the circuit of punk in this neighborhood. So we are going to focus on two different things. The first one is how solidarity and mutual aid are being conceptualized by this punk community of Chapinero. And also, we are going to talk about the impact of coronavirus in the punk scene. We are going to do all of this with the cartography we told you about, and also with interviews, where we have interviewed people or the owners of pub, disco, restaurants, tattoo shops, clothing shops, and screen printing workshops.
Okay, first, it's important to talk a little bit about Chapinero. Chapinero is a neighborhood located in Bogotá, capital city of Colombia. Here, you can see a map. In this neighborhood, art and culture is so strong, and the punk scene also. As you could see, Chapinero is represented by the red part. Okay, next to talk about art and culture in Colombia, we have to mention that these concepts are contained in Orange Economy. In general, in few words, Orange Economy is a concept developed by the current government that reduces art and culture to market logics and focus just in big industries in the economic value of art and culture. So this concept is so limited and making visible a huge part of cultural scene and the huge value, the huge social and political value that also art and culture have. Okay, to overcome the crisis, government generate 4 decrees that in general... 4 decrees that are not important to mention because they are so limited and they don't help the punk scene. Here we could see some data about the behavior and the impact of coronavirus in a cultural area. What we could see here is that in number of occupied persons, it is a decrease of minus 34.7%, and the most affected area are cultural industries.
So, to talk about the research project, we have made this cartography or this map, where we have identified this circuit of punk in Chapinero, the punk scene of Chapinero. So there you can find like the different places, the pubs, discos, like screen printing shops, rehearsal rooms. And we are, this is a still an ongoing research, so we have not interviewed all of this collective. But in our presentation, in this one, we are going to share like the interviews we made with these spaces. So it's a rehearsal room, a bookstore, a screen printing workshop, a food delivery service, a restaurant, and also and a pub. So the first one is called Alterna. It's a rehearsal room and it doesn't exist no more due to coronavirus. So the owner of Alterna told us that the punk and hardcore scene has been affected, mainly the bands that went to their rehearsal room were hardcore and punk bands, and he says that there are no concerts, no pubs, and no rehearsal of some bands, so it's difficult to maintain the scene this way, because what gives the essence of the scene is the union, the collectivity, to have a beer together, the mosh pit, and all of these things don't work in the virtual space. So basically, they had also problems to stream the concerts because some productions were not possible. And in underground scene, this is even more difficult because it doesn't obey like kind of the market values. And that's why, due to the decrease of their activities, they had to close. The second experience is a bookstore. It's called La Valija de Fuego. And this bookstore, Marco, the owner, told us that we could see like the impact of coronavirus in the cultural scene in general, not only in the punk scene, has very big, because there are no spaces for cultural interaction, there is no collective construction of punk, and this means the loss of counter-hegemonic spaces and debate, especially we are talking about the territoriality in Chapinero, where, as Paola said before, the punk scene was very strong. Now, some of these places had to close, so there is a loss of this nomad territoriality and the spaces of reference, and also of the counter-hegemonic thinking. According to La Valija de Fuego, there is a misconception of the concept of mutual aid, because instead of being based in reciprocity, it has a mercantilist conception. So he gives us, Marco the owner gives us like two examples. On the one hand, we have like the picture of the people that are just donors. I give because I have enough money, but they don't get involved in the projects. And on the other hand, we have the figure of the sponsor, people or other collectives that decide to give money, but because it gives like a good image to that person or to the collective. That is why he says, solidarity is kind of a spectacle in the coronavirus crisis. They have made different initiatives regarding solidarity and mutual aid, especially crowdfunding. They received some money to pay wages and so on. And they have also helped other communities. The thing is that he recognizes there are less activities than before, but they are making now more things in the digital format. But this gives way to censorship in digital space because of the control, for example, of songs or of some concerts in this space. And also he mentions two important concepts during coronavirus, the digital hyperconsumism and digital capitalism. The next experience, it's called Mala Influencia. It's a screen printing workshop. And she has developed many, many initiatives. I don't have time here to explain them all, but this girl has developed a lot of initiatives linked to mutual aid and solidarity. So she says that the impact of social distancing due to coronavirus has been very high. So once again, she emphasizes that there are no concerts, no spaces for opinion, no direct interaction, and that cultural events are almost inexistent. So this is why counterculture is being affected. And although there are like many digital proposals, it is not enough to maintain the scene because there are no like live concerts or direct contact with the community. Another thing she mentions is that the social protest stopped because like you are not allowed as before to go to the streets and protest. And especially here, this is another research we are finishing. We started on January, and it's about the Colombian, the Colombian national strike during 2019 and 2020, and the music scene participation. And as we can see here, punk on the left side is one of the scenes that participated most during the social protest. So, she, as I told you before, she has made a lot of initiatives with no government aid, and the aid mainly has come from normal people. So this is a quote I would like to read to you, and she says, "It is not only to be a spectator and to complain about the situation of a corrupt country. Building structures of support, union and affection is an alternative that can change things. This aid is not only for the punk community, but for anyone who needs it. During this process, people have helped us with their savings, sending money or other stuff, with no support of enterprises nor government." To continue with this next initiative, it's called La Calderita Vegana. It's a project of food delivery, and it's vegan food, so the political values they have, it's like it's anti-species, anti-fascist, and anti-capitalist food delivery. And she says that the impact of coronavirus has had like two phases, especially in La Calderita Vegana, her collective. They have increased income, and this is like quite weird for the coronavirus crisis. But she also says that as there is a limitation of physical contact and knowing other projects, finally all the products she sells, it's like a kind of commercial transaction, and she doesn't get to know like these other people. And she mentions that in Chapinero, the neighborhood we are researching, and the punk scene of Chapinero has kind of a privilege because this neighborhood is like middle class, and it's not so bad as other neighborhoods in Bogotá, especially the south, for example, has a lot of problems because there is like a social class struggle there. So finally, Chapinero is not so bad. And she mentions that countercultural thinking, like in the context of the pandemic, could be an opportunity to rethink a lot of things. But when talking about solidarity and mutual aid, she is also very critical on these concepts, especially because she says that there is no scene beyond the party, and that there is no organization or like a collective organization. Before, we were saying that the space of the concert is very important to maintain the scene. And what she mentions is that there is actually no scene beyond the party, that this pandemic has demonstrated this phenomena, and that the discourse on solidarity and mutual aid is like beautiful in the punk community, but that the pandemic has shown that the scene is hollow. One of the next projects we want to share with you, it's Mandragora, and it's a vegetarian restaurant. It doesn't exist anymore. And when we were talking to Mandragora, they were asking like, what is punk, and if punk is a counterculture, because on the one hand, we have the limitation of spaces once again, that there are no concerts and that there is no rehearsal of bands. And also he mentions, as La Calderita Vegana before, that there is a center-periphery logic in Chapinero with the privileges of Chapinero, and especially like the middle class and all these things, and that we have to question if really punk is a counterculture more than a scene that is gathered around a gig. Because in Bogotá and in other places in the world, the punk scene, especially white, middle class, heterosexual, masculine, and especially here in Bogotá, where I told you before about the Venezuelan immigration, there are cases of xenophobia, and also in the punk community with Venezuelan punks, for example. So this is a problem, and we have to question if really punk could be considered a counterculture in this sense. he had to close Mandragora because the first days of the lockdown, the selling only was the 10% of the food they were selling before. And they received like some crowdfunding and some money of the people to pay the wages and the rent of the space. But apart from that, now, like with his band, they are doing like they are selling some t-shirts and some music to give the money to people in need. And finally, this is our last initiative or our last space in Chapinero. It's called Jolly Roger. It's a pub. And they used to put like punk music and sell burgers. And mostly every weekend they had concerts, but they went to have it to from having like a lot of concerts every weekend to having nothing at all. And in June they thought of closing the space, but finally they decided to fight and to maintain it. And nowadays what they do is like the only thing they have is that they sell burgers to the people. Like it's like kind of a delivery. It's not a pub anymore, although they still maintain the place. So, finally, to end our presentation, we are going to give the conclusion of our research, like talking about this concept of anarchy in crisis and punk in crisis during the pandemic. So, regarding the concepts of mutual aid and solidarity, we have to say that the logic of the orange economy and the state is insufficient and only valid under capitalism. So all these decrees and all these measures they have, it's only like for big industries. For example, the punk scene would not be inside like this concept, but we also have to say that they are not interested in having, budget like received from the government or from private industries. So they also have a conception that solidarity is necessary to sustain the underground because it's not inside these big capitalist logics. And although they think that, it's also this concept of the mercantilist ideas of solidarity and mutual aid, as we said before, regarding donors and sponsors. And in this sense, although these mercantilist ideas and all these things we can find in the punk scene, that there are many initiatives that support the most needed people, not only inside the punk community, like this community, but also outside of it, like the people that have lost their jobs or indigenous people that have lived like the forced displacement in Bogotá. So, despite of coronavirus, we can say that these spaces have not seek for the state or for private enterprises, and they are developing their own initiatives regarding mutual aid and solidarity.
I will pass this fast because we don't have enough time. Minerva already mentioned some things. First, about the impact of COVID, we have to say that the gigs are central. So, not having a physical space affect the dynamics of punk scenes and question the existence of this scene itself without concerts. About the privilege of Chapinero that she already mentioned, this privilege makes that some places and some people don't feel the impact of COVID so strong. And last, virtually is not sufficient, is not enough, because for example, in virtual spaces, cannot make other transactions like Barrett, broke bonders, and in general are a lot of projects that could not be recognized or shown by virtual part.
Thank you. So if you have any questions, we will be glad to answer them. Thanks.